go ahead. And so thanks for inviting us to give a talk. I'm Natalie DuPre. I'm a graduate from the Harvard TH Chan School of Public Health, and I have a great team of both staff, faculty, and with the HILT funds, we've been able to support more students, which is really the big goal here. I'm excited to share some of the work that we've done to empower student voices and to equip them with the resources and knowledge that they need to develop their own podcasts as an innovative learning and communication tool. So at my 2017 graduation from the Harvard Chan School, Gina McCarthy, the former head of the EPA, gave a really inspirational speech to my student colleagues and to me, saying it's not just enough to do science, we have to speak for science in the ways that non-scientists, aka real people, can understand. Take off your lab coats and start practicing this. And this was something that was really inspiring as a graduate student and made me start to think about ways that I can practice communication of science. So my personal journey, well, I have a question for you all. Who here has listened to a podcast in the last 30 days? Okay, lots of people. So listening to podcasts has become more and more common, where nearly a quarter of adults listen to podcasts regularly. And it seems to be growing in the last years. So as I was riding on bikes from Boston and to Cambridge, podcasts were very crucial for me in my time, in my commute. And in thinking about at the time I was working as a curriculum fellow, and we were developing online resources for our online master's in public health students. So the idea came to me as podcasting being a way to communicate science and to engage both our students and our alumni in this program. So I connected with some digital learning experts to develop a podcast to see what does it take to develop a podcast. And through that process and that experience, I realized that there's so much to learn about podcasting. And ultimately, I was interested, are other students interested in developing podcasts? So as part of this grant, we built a podcasting infrastructure sustainable for student use on the Longwood Medical Campus. So we purchased the hardware, the microphones, and created user guides, and you're welcome to go see those at our table. And this was great. We've got user guides to walk students through how to do this. But in this fall, we developed an on-campus workshop where about 25 students came to learn about how to podcast. And with that feedback from that survey or from that on-campus workshop, we developed an online workshop that is being piloted as we speak. But this walks students through the basics of how to do a podcast, some of the ways to responsibly tell a story, as well as producing the podcast with free software. So this is what we're really excited to share with people later on once we get through. But we're also happy to share the on-campus materials that we developed. And here's some of the results from the participants that completed the surveys. 87% of our participants had no previous experience podcasting, yet nearly all of them thought that podcasts were a useful tool for learning a topic. And they also thought, the majority of them agreed that they'd like to use it as part of course assignments. So this was really interesting to learn. Of course, these people are highly motivated because they're coming to our podcast workshop. But after the workshop, this was a two-day workshop, so we didn't have as many people respond to the last survey, but they evaluated our workshop as being effective or very effective. That's indicated by the 4 or 5. And we, about 3/4 of them said that they were still interested in creating their own podcast despite all the work that it takes to build a podcast. And they also said that they would do this within a year. So we're really looking forward to seeing what they've got for us. But the last aim of this is to build a podcast library of student-generated podcasts. So what can they tell us about science that needs to be out in the world? So we're really excited about building this, and this is kind of where we're at currently. And we really need some student-developed podcasts, and we're thinking of fun ways to engage students to produce a podcast. So we're thinking about developing a podcast challenge over at the Harvard Chan School. We're also thinking about ways to integrate it into coursework as a potential option for, say, a final project. I'm currently at a different institution right now and teaching, and two of my students have created a podcast. And I will say it's bringing out some of the best qualities in people that aren't necessarily reflected in a standard test with multiple choice questions. So, and we're working on developing the second part of our online workshop, that will hopefully be out soon. But it's been a really great experience working with Hilt. Jamie and Cassie and Dan were really great support for all of, half of our original team is now not in Boston, Massachusetts, and they're really supportive of supporting us to develop this idea. And I think it also speaks to the great qualities of digital learning. We were having meetings from across the world, across the country, and able to develop this podcast project. And without Hilt, we would not have been able to do that, so, or be here physically. So come by and stop and chat and see the materials that we've made. We'd be happy to share them if you all are interested in making a podcast yourself.